guys, it's a beautiful afternoon and you're here back at Dexter's World Channel. In the last previous videos that we have uploaded, we talked about the process of breeding this betta, wherein we made series of videos, and actually we have uploaded 3 videos already, and this is the 4th series about breeding betta fish. And I am so glad that we have elicited so many opinions, reactions, and even positive, negative comments about our breeding. And I would like to invite you to please comment whether it is a constructive comment, or you are going to also share your view or your own method about betta breeding. It's much better. Now today we're gonna check all these boxes if the eggs have been hatched already by the male bettas. So we will check this out. Actually, I have opened already the first box, and you will see that there are plenty of babies now swimming, and the father is carefully taking care of them. And maybe you will ask, will you feed these babies immediately? My answer is no. We will feed them tomorrow, because they are hatched maybe early yesterday or maybe early today. So the first feeding will be tomorrow. And what we're gonna feed, of course, I have here a BBS baby brine shrimps, and I will teach you on how to hatch this one. And it's also very early to get the father, because the babies need some assistance from their father. So tomorrow we will get the father, and maybe we'll introduce the first food. So we'll cover this one. What about the second box? Well, of course, the second box is also very successful, and you can see that there are babies also freely swimming, and they are due to eat their first food tomorrow. I am excited. Maybe you cannot see it clearly because the water turns brown, dark brown, because of the talisay leaves, but it's there. I can see it. What about the third box? Well, I cannot see babies on this third box, but the father still under the leaf, and there are bubbles, so we can safely assume that there are eggs inside. Well, I can see babies here. This is baby. Wow, there are babies. Yes. So that's it. Now, we will cover this one. What about the fourth box? There are so many bubbles here, and the bubbles are already scattered, so that's an indication that there are already babies that are attached to it. So we can safely assume that tomorrow they're gonna swim freely, and that's it. Wow, this is the fifth one, and you know that this is the wife killer. When we first introduced the first female betta, the female betta was killed by this one. We introduced another wife, another girlfriend, and they are successful. And you will see that there are so many eggs down here. So we will not disturb. The babies are not yet freely swimming. So we will cover this back. And what about this one? Of course, you can see babies. There are plenty of babies, but some of them are still hiding and attached to the nest, to the bubbles. So we cannot yet remove the father. What about this one? Wow, this one has plenty of babies, and there are no bubbles anymore. So tomorrow we're gonna get the father, and then we will introduce the first feeding. What about the seventh box? The seventh box is also having babies already, and the father is closely watching these babies. Well, this is the first day of the babies. They are hatched today, earlier today, and maybe last night some of them were hatched last night. And we will feed them tomorrow. The reason for this is because they are not yet ready to eat the baby brine shrimps. They are still developing their mouth, and tomorrow we can safely feed them their first food. Wow, these are massive babies. There are plenty. You will touch this flower, of course you will see that the babies are already there, and the father is carefully watching them. And about this one, there are still bubbles, but yes, there are plenty, very plenty. And this has the plentiest babies this time. Wow, you can see here. Tomorrow, we're gonna introduce the first food and what kind of food we're going to feed them. Of course, I don't want to feed Dapnya because in other places, Dapnya cannot be catch or you cannot see Dapnyas in other places. So what I am going to do is to hatch the baby brine shrimps because the baby brine shrimps are available in our local pet stores. I'm sure that in your place you can also see baby brine shrimps. Well, what I have here is 200 grams of baby brine shrimps. It's here. You will see this one. And we will get the half of it, mix this with 1/2 tablespoon of salt. So I have prepared a button for this one. So we will divide this into half. And I'm using a funnel. So we will put this one, half of this one. Okay, maybe it's already half. And then we will put 1/2 tablespoon salt. I'm using the refined salt. So the salt is there. And we will erate this one. I am using this 1 liter. This is 1.5 or 1 liter. I think this is 1 liter. And I made a small hole on the cup. And we will connect this one directly to the hose. So this is the hose. And this hose has air. Okay? So we'll put this aerator like that over here. We will aerate this one. Yes. It's too tight. Maybe we can add more air. You can have other techniques. Maybe you can turn this upside down and put some silicone over here. You can devise your own. What is important is you are aerating this baby brine shrimps, and this one is mixed with salt. And tomorrow, maybe around 3 o'clock in the afternoon, this baby brine shrimps will be hatched. And this is the time that we're gonna feed our baby Betta. Okay, our baby Betta will get their first food tomorrow. Okay, so we will expect that our next video will be the feeding of the Betta pride. You know, in breeding Bettas, the feeding is one of the most significant. It's crucial because if we feed prematurely, then it will cause death. If we'll also delay the feeding, it will also cause death. And after this, we'll receive their first food on the following day or on the third day. We're gonna transfer them to a bigger container. And in the manner of transferring, it's also very crucial. Why? Because you have to make sure that your water is really that condition. Well, of course, I have here a big basin, and this water is prepared yesterday, and maybe 2 days after, we're gonna transfer this baby Betta over here. Because if we will not transfer, as they grow big, they will also die, because this water has so much of ammonia already that they have to be transferred in a fresh water. The moment we transfer, we have to acclimatize for 3 hours. We will put this container over here and acclimatize for 3 hours, because if the temperature of the water is not the same, then all of these babies will die. And you will see, you will wonder, where are the babies? They all died because they were transferred in a container with the water that has different temperature. So that's all that we can share with you today. I hope you will continue to support us. Please like and share our videos, hit that notification bell, and subscribe to our channel so that you will be notified of our upcoming videos only here at Dexter's World.